Quickly, before we wrap up the interview and just finalize the journalist issue, do you want to respond to VBS there and what Blade was saying?
No. There's a conflation there. Our attack on why we raised a very critical question here, I think, Leanne, which you would probably also sympathize with. Why would the Zondo Commission investigating state capture of the Gupta family, a Gupta family that owned a newspaper, New Age, that owned a broadcasting station, ANN7, and used some of these entities to constitute its corrupt activities with the state? Why would you go and hold an investigation that investigates that in the building of Tiso Black Star, which owns Business Day TV, Sunday Times, Business Day, Sowetan? It turns the commission into a Mickey Mouse. And that is the public reputation, the perception that it creates. What is the Zondo Commission doing at the headquarters of Tiso Black Star? Wasn't there a public building? Even if it's a court, even if it's the constitutional court, and the places that are owned by the state, that are owned by the public, where the Zondo Commission could have been constituted and held. That's what we were raising. So to divert attention from holding you accountable about why go into a media house when you are investigating other medias, to divert attention, I must speak about VBS. I must speak about being scared that the commission is going to investigate us. The commission is not investigating the EFF. It will never reveal anything about the EFF or its leaders. You know why?
Why?
Because we're not in government. Because we're not ministers, we're not mayors, we're not director generals. All of us come from the streets of activism.
Yeah.
All of us come from the student movement, from the youth movement. We were not there. We never met the Guptas. They didn't even think about calling us. So to divert attention from holding you accountable about this important factor of the State Capture Commission of Inquiry happening at the headquarters of Sunday Times. No, I must come. I must just talk about VBS all the time. VBS all the time. Ah, because why?
You
don't want to be held accountable.
Is your party still, I believe, today writing to all the ministers to find out whether they held any mortgage bonds or anything with VBS? I've heard that that's what's going to be happening. Is it still on the cards
today? We wrote to them about the businesses that they've been doing with the companies in which Pravin Gordhan's daughter set as a director.
Are you not happy with his response to his
daughter? You know, it doesn't matter. His response doesn't matter. We wanted to demonstrate media unbiased. You must just ask yourself, my father is a finance minister, and all the businesses in which I sit as a director, even if I'm a non-executive director, get millions and millions of tenders from the government. If my father was an African leader, my face, my name would be in all the front pages of newspapers. That's the unfair. That's what we're trying to demonstrate to you, that Anisha Gordhan sits in all these boards. And you know what happened? All the print media came to defend Anisha. Even before Pravin Gordhan responded, they said, no, the EFF is trying to tarnish the minister, is trying to shift attention. What we were trying to do is to demonstrate to you that only the cousins and the families of certain people will make it to the front page. Only them are subjected to radical scrutiny. Our interaction with Minister Pravin Gordhan firstly had to do with, number one, it is revealed that the guy lied to Parliament. Media rights in his defense. He lied on two occasions. He lied in relation to an EFF question. He lied in relation to a DA question. He also lied in an interview with Stephen Crudis. No, when all that is revealed in his affidavit, which had to be re-edited after he postponed to come and testify, no, they are not writing and doing radical questioning like they were doing around everybody else who lied about their meeting with the Guptas. They write in his defense. So we are like, what is happening here? And in an attempt to demonstrate that the judgment, the tools of judgment, choose who you are. They choose, you know, to the extent that they choose the color of your skin and the ranking in the black order of oppression.
Yeah, yeah.
And that's what we're trying to demonstrate. So after doing that, now our fight with him has to do with the role that he plays in general in defense of white monopoly capital.
Okay.
We are beyond the Gupta state capture.
Yeah, I understand that. And also, I just want to bring up more on the VBS, because it was on, I think it was on Friday night, that Malema was saying that he has a list of ministers that have loans with VBS. And what he and the party are still saying, do not close VBS, arrest the criminals. Rather arrest them. Who are these ministers you're talking about? Can we name them?
We're going to do that.
When are you naming them?
We will, as soon as, you see, we've got several sources, ne? And when you've got a source that is given, firstly, we've requested transcripts. And in the transcripts, we're going to demonstrate that everybody kept being asked if they gave money to the EFF. And then we're in possession of some sensitive information about people who had loans there, and they were requested to shift them before the report was published from VBS to NetBank. We're going to name these ministers. We're going to name the political parties. And our task in doing so, part of what we would like to do, is to even publish that information, because there's now, like, you know, a contest of, like, providing evidence. So in the past, all I had to do was to give you a claim about Zuma. The media would go through its investigative arms to go find it. These days, we must do it on their behalf. I mean, very soon, we'll probably have to have our own Amabungani in the EFF, because we have to even do the job of finding you, as the media, the evidence to try and expose the corruption. And not just in relation to VBS. What we're trying to demonstrate in relation to VBS is a much more fundamental point, is that a black bank was shut down. A black bank was shut down. And it was shut down in a way in which politically they knew the people who are going to come in defense of this is the EFF. What do we do? Put them in a corner, blame them and corruption, tarnish their image, because they will sit in a corner and keep quiet. Had we not been done that, we would have even joined the application to oppose the Reserve Bank's application in court for VBS to be liquidated. So that is the chess game we're involved in here in relation to power, because VBS posed the biggest threat to white monopoly capital in the banking and financial sector in general.
This isn't enough time, because there's so much more I want to talk to you about. Still the issues of Brian Chivon, but it's still hanging over the party. It's still the link there with VBS, but we can't, unfortunately, get into it. But I think you've stated your view.
Thank you.
There's one last thing I want to say, and just as we wrap this up, and if we could do this quickly. When you call journalists, or Malema calls journalists Satan, as he did, I think it was on Saturday night, for one of the journalists, Paulie van Wyk, and I know that the EFF have got a big, big agenda with her, and she may have agenda against you, but is this the wrong way? Don't you agree these are the wrong things to be doing in public platforms?
No, we name call each other all the time. Journalists call us names as well. I mean, if you don't have a thick skin, don't join, don't descend in the arena. Don't make an opinion, just write a balanced story, and don't claim that you've got evidence you don't.
All right.
You understand? You know, they publish evidences, for an example, in relation to the SACP, to say this is the proof that SACP got 3 million from VBS. Have you seen any evidence that says EFF or Malema or Floyd Chibambu? You've never seen such a thing. But they are writing and they say it's the truth. And they keep changing. The last time Floyd got 10 million, where did that go? It's nowhere to be found. Now the focus is on the 1.4 million that we received. We don't know. Where is the evidence for that? So when we say it's satanic, we think it is, because you are trying to silence us from stopping the shutting down of VBS. And that's really a bad thing to do.
All right, we'll leave it there. Thank you for your time. Always interesting talking to you. It certainly is. Talking to us, Mbuyiseni Ndlozi from the EFF, giving us a whole range of issues. But I get back to the beginning. They have accepted to meet with SANEF to talk about the attacks on journalists and how we get around that. All right, so at least one great thing's come out of this interview. Thanks very much for joining us, and we'll see you after the break. Stay tuned.